Hello everyone, welcome to the Global Biz Apps Weekend 2021 powered by D365 Champs. It's day two today and we hope you are doing well and keeping safe. I'm Ankush Grover moderating this session along with Dipesh Somani. This session is presented by Nijo Joseph. Nijo will be talking about Power Apps accessibility and usability considerations. He is a Biz Apps MVP working as a senior analyst at KPMG Malta. He's a blogger, speaker, event organizer, and Kerala Power Platform user group lead. Before I hand over this session to Nijo, I would like to mention that if you have any queries, please feel free to drop it in the chat window. We'll take them either during this session, if possible, or during the Q&A time. Thank you again for joining and enjoy the session. Nijo, yeah. Over to you.
And just adding one fun fact, and another person from the MVP family, welcome Nijo to take up this particular one. I'm co-moderating this one with Ankur. So if you want to learn the things in a fun way, he does something very different, right? Just a fun fact to add for this particular MVP. So Nijo makes what is called as cartoons, right? And if you want to learn via cartoons, you should check out his blog, right? He is a very creative person and he does it in that way, right? And you should check out, that is pretty unique for him. Over to you, Nijo, for a fun learning around accessibility and usability considerations.
Thank you all. Thank you so much. First of all, thank you everyone for joining today's session. Let me share my screen. I'm just adding my presentation. One moment. Let's see if we can. Yeah, I'm just adding it. Give me a moment. I'm just adding it. So let me know if you're able to see the presentation. I'm just adding it. So before we start, first of all, I would like to thank D365 Champ, then Microsoft and Dynamicity for organizing this wonderful continuous learning event. I would like to call it a continuous learning event, like 24 hours or 48 hours, 2 days full of learning. And, you know, a weekend is going to be, I know those who will join the session, a weekend is going to be well utilized with immense knowledge. So thank you again. I hope you can see my screen now, right?
Or, yes, it's visible.
Yes. Okay. Thank you. So today's session is kind of an awareness session. I'm sorry, this session would have maybe like 50 part of it will be kind of a theory side, and maybe like another 50 will be demos and how we can make it accessible in Power Apps or the solution you create using Power Platform. So before we begin, just a quick introduction about me. I am working as a Dynamics 365 senior analyst and a Microsoft MVP. And I do coordinate different activities and community events. So feel free to ping me in social media, especially in LinkedIn. And like, you can invite me for any events, any collaboration. I'm more than happy to join or help the best or provide my best of into it. So feel free to connect with me. So let's start. So today's agenda is basically, you know, first session will be kind of what is accessibility, kind of in a very high level overview and awareness. I won't be going into very detail because there are a lot of documentations and guidelines available, but I will just tell you what is it, where can you find more details so that you can go and check. That will be the first part. Then I'll be sharing some of my personal experiences and my own limitations in taking the presentation and everything. I'll tell the reason also why I went with the cartoon instead of writing a complete blog. I will include that also. Then some of my friends' experiences and why I decided to take this particular topic. Then as we know, a small demo, how we can make or some of the basic things we can consider when we create an application. So that's all of the things we gonna cover today. And please feel free to stop or stop in between if you feel I'm going too fast or if something is not very clear. So please feel free to do so. I know sometimes I may go a bit fast. So please feel free to do that thing. So next slide, we'll start. So next slide, what it is saying is that what is accessibility? I know most of you know what is accessibility or what accessibility means. Accessibility means like we are making the place around us, the world around us, accessible for people with different type of limitations. Limitation as in it could be visual, people with color blindness or low vision or totally blank. These people might be using high contrast systems or braille or other helping aids to use the facilities around us. For example, you know, if you go to ATM or printer machine, everywhere you can see small dots, which is help to people with lower vision or people are familiar with the braille. Again, auditory, people with hearing disabilities or hearing limitations. They will be using hearing aids or they'll be using sign languages. So these are the things they use. If you go, wherever you go out, you know, bus station, hospital, everywhere there is a bigger sign so that people with, you know, visual, auditory limitation can understand that thing. Again, physical limitation, people who cannot move around, move their hands or legs, they might be using wheelchairs. If you go to a bus station or store, wherever it is, there will be a wheelchair access or a parking lot. There will be a parking lot for people who are using wheelchairs so that we are making it accessible for them. Again, same with people with speech limitation, cognitive or understanding learning limitations. There are different things around us to help these people. So, in a simple way, we are making it accessible for everyone else. And this can be temporary and permanent also. What I mean by temporary, let's say you met with an accident. You cannot move your hand. You might be using Google Assist, Siri, or Bixby to use a mobile phone. Or you cannot move around. You might be using a wheelchair for temporary purpose. And if you think you are fully able, you don't need these things, just think this thing, you are getting older. As and when you get aged, your vision may not be that good as today. Your hearing skills may not be that as good today. Or you may have face of limitation in mobility or moving your hands or something. So you may have to use some of these features. I'm not saying you will definitely need, but some of us may need. So we cannot ignore accessibility considerations in the world we are in. And today, our world is more concerned about these features because, you know, there are certain things that are very mandatory, like using braille graphs to help elderly people. So these things are becoming mandatory as well as kind of responsibility for us, make the world accessible for everyone. And it can be useful for people without any disability or fully abled people also. This can be useful. For example, you know, you are in a crowd and your friend is standing like a couple of meters away from you. You might be using a sign language to show it everything is okay, good. Or, you know, you might be knowingly or unknowingly, you will also be using these things. Or you are driving a car. Then you want to find a hospital or a gas station. What do you think more easier, seeing the hospital icon in the signboard or reading out a board hospital or gas station? Obviously, reading the signboard or seeing the signboard is much easier. So these features are not only for people with limitations, people are fully able people also make, or these facilities or these considerations make their life or everyone's life more easier. Now, these are the examples we discuss about, you know, physical world. Now coming into software side, just realize, you know, the same set of considerations we need to make when you develop an application. I'm sure most of us haven't considered these accessibility limitations when you develop an application. I haven't considered. I used to consider only when I'm asked to develop an application specifically for people or kids with disabilities, or I have some disability or some of my loved ones has these features, then I will just think about it. Okay, let's say if this person is using, this feature would be helpful for him or her. So that's the thing I have seen the software side. And especially when you think about Power Apps or Power Platform, this is not about the pro developers. If you think about business developers, you know, mostly originally they might be developing an application for single use, or my own use I'll be developing. So I'm creating from my own point of view. I may not have any disabilities and any limitation, so I'll be creating for myself. Then later, if I find this is very useful, then I'll be using, you know, I'll be sharing that with my team member. There might be some people with this kind of limitation in my team, and they may not be, or they may not use this app because they cannot use it properly. They are facing some limitations. So you need to consider certain things to make the apps you develop also usable for others as well. So let's see some of the examples where we need to give some considerations. This is a screenshot from Amazon. So let's see. Or let's say a person with color blindness is using this or searching for this t-shirt. You can see it is in green color and there are different color options. A person with color blindness or limitation might be seeing this t-shirt in a gray color or a black color, and all these dots they might be seeing in the same color, a single color. So they might not be able to, they cannot properly select or decide which color they need. So that will be an issue. You can see it over here. See, these are different colors. And what if everything is in red color or, you know, gray color? They may not be able to use it. But, you know, if you think, see, if you go inside this Amazon, it has given the color option over here so that if they are using a screen reader or if they are using or, you know, their color blind, they can see what color they have selected rather than simply looking the colors given over here. Or if you go to another slide, this is an example from simplyaccessible.com. So this t-shirt, okay, this is in blue color. You have given the colors. A person with visual limitation may not be able to distinguish different colors, but you can make it accessible without much effort, simply giving the color name over here. You can see it over here, right? Blue, olive green, red, pink. So now with a small tweak, you're making your application accessible for people with disability as well. It won't cost much of your time. It's a very small thing. So if you go to the next slide, this is a Power BI dashboard or Power BI chart. So this is a standard chart which a normal person will see. And these are the different way the same chart is viewed by people with different disabilities. See, this is not at all similar to this one. The colors are totally different. So you cannot solely rely on color or, you know, when you design an application, you cannot totally depend on color to say or to give them some message. Of course, you can use it, but along with that, you should give some naming or some other alternative to people with limitation to understand. So I hope you got some of idea, some why this is important, or you know why some of the apps you made, some of the users, your end users are finding it difficult to use their application. It is not their problem. They might have some issues or they might have some limitations. So you need to consider this aspect when you develop an application. And I'm very sure you all know what is this. This is a clear example, a person or same thing perceived by different way or seen differently by different people. You know what this was something which took the internet, I think 2 or 3 years back. So when you decide something, do not solely depend on color. Just make it accessible for everyone. So go back, let's see some more example. Let's take the current same background of this screen, this presentation tech. You know, if I use instead of this blue or black color, if I'm using white color, it may look very elegant or neat for a person with normal vision, but a person with lower vision or color blindness may not be able to read this. And this is a site called contrast ratio. If you go out here, you can see the rating for this one. As per the standards, this is in red color. This is not readable for people with even minute disability, visible or vision disability or blindness. They won't be able to read it at all. So you need to consider this. For me personally, this looked very elegant and neat, this color combination, but this is not readable. This is what this will happen when you decide an application also. Let's say Power App or a Power BI dashboard, something, or you're preparing a report. So if you are using this kind of color combination, they may not be able to read, or all of your end users may not be able to read it or perceive the actual message. For example, it may pass the UAT, it may get the sign off because people involved in the UAT or all other faces are fully able people. But when it finally released to end users, some people may find it difficult to use your application. So do not do such things. You need to be considerate or careful while creating an application. Just make sure your app is usable by everyone. So let's go to some more thing. So these are the standard tools used by, there might be other tools as well. You see, I'm also not very familiar with everyone, all of these tools, but you know, these are the standard things I know. There are some people with, you know, color blindness or blind problem, they might be using a screen reader. In Windows, it is called Windows Narrator, and iOS or macOS, there is VoiceOver. In phone, I think Android, it is TalkBack. Yeah. So these kind of facilities are there. It will read out what is in your screen so that people can understand it. Again, screen magnifier. If you have some problem, people might be using magnifier to magnify the screen and read. Then color contrast so that they can easily understand, distinguish between different elements in the screen. Then people might be using keyboard alone or mouse alone. Some people may not be able to use the touch screen, so they will be using keyboard or mouse alone. Then speech to text. Some people may not be able to use the keyboard properly, so they will be using voice assistant or speech text to convert it into a text or command system to certain operations. So these are some of the tools used by people with disabilities. So now let's see what are the guidelines internationally available. WCAG, Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, published by W3C. So there are certain set of standards or guidelines to follow when you develop an application. There are different versions, WCAG 1.0, 2.0, 2.1, 2.2 is in draft. Basically, there are certain, these are the initial set of guidelines released, then 2 was released, including the guidelines from version 1. And 2.1 was released, including guidelines from 1, 2.0, and 2. Now, I think 2.2 is in draft, it is not fully released, but there are some guidelines being added. Let's see what are these. I'm not going into very detail. I'm just giving you very high level overview of this thing because I know, you know, it will be fully theoretical if I go explaining everything. But you can obviously simply search WCAG and you can go to their website. It is very clearly written what all are the things you need to consider when you develop an application. These are the four main principles. Inside the principle, there are some guidelines for each principle. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. So we were discussing about the guidelines on accessibility side. So WCAG is Web Content Accessibility Guidelines. So these are standard set of guidelines published by W3C. There are different versions, 1, 2.0, 2.1, and 2.2. These are kind of 2.2 is in draft, and this kind of a backward compatible. Like if you are meeting 2.1, you should be meeting 2.0 and 2.1 as well. So these are the standard principles. Now, let's see on a high level, what are these principles and guidelines? There are four major principles. Inside each principle, there are different guidelines. So first principle is perceivable. Perceivable means, you know, it should be understandable or kind of graspable by other people. Like, for example, there should be text alternate. One of the guidelines is that there should be text alternative for everything, for all non-text contents in your screen. Like, for example, there is an image. You need to give an alt text for it. For example, there is a website, news website saying Prime Minister or the President is inaugurating a specific office. You are giving the image of that. So a person using a screen reader may not cannot read the image and say what is in the image. But if you give an alt text inside that for that image, screen reader will read out that thing, image of the Prime Minister inaugurating the office. So that person using a screen reader can understand what is there or what is a placeholder, what the placeholder trying to convey to him. So these kind of stuff should be there. Or if you're using a video, it is best or better to give a transcript of the video. So people who cannot view the video using a screen reader or some other means of accessibility aids, they can read the, you know, transcript and understand what is a speaker saying in the video. Same way, whatever it is there, and it is best not to use, you know, I have seen some websites or people just crop the image with some text and paste that in the website. So we have to read even some code. You know, if you're pasting in your blog, I have seen people take a screenshot from Visual Studio and pasting in the blog. So people, you know, it is not a best practice, good practice. People with some limitations or, you know, reading problem may not be able to read from an image. Sometimes even the image clarity may not be that good. It is always good to use the text in your application or website, wherever it is. Next thing, it is there are other principles also. I'm not going through each and every guidelines in the principle. It will take more time. I'm just giving a high level idea so that you can go to their site and understand or read through it. And you know, not all the principles are adoptable for all the application. There might be some limitation implementing that, but try your best to include these in your application. Again, operable. Don't assume like all the users are going to use touch screen or mouse. They might be using, you know, keyboard alone. So just make sure, you know, your application is fully operable using keyboard. You know, in keyboard, you know, these people might be using tab and the up and down, home arrows, these keys to move around. So make sure these are moving in the intended manner. It should not be like there is a name in the, like, for example, you have to fill in fields 1, 2, 3. If you tap from here, it should not go to the field in the lower bottom side. It should not be like that. It should be in a proper order. What you expect the user, what you are expecting your users to do, make sure it is navigating users the same way using tabbing. Just go through the previous canvas app you have developed and see the tabbing in the screen and see whether it is going properly or in the expected manner. sometimes I have seen some might go in keyboard kind of a trap, like it will get into some section or container here, it will stay inside this thing, it won't go to the submit button or other button. So make sure your app is developed such a manner. Again, understandable. It's the same kind of a principle, like it should be understandable, readable, predictable manner. The application of website, go with the standard. Do not go with the, you know, don't try to make it so flashy or, you know, robust kind of a manner, like it will be so flashy. I'll tell you one example. I was using one website recently and I was trying to see my profile. Normally where in a website, the profiles are located in the top right corner. But in this website, it was in the lower left corner. And I, even without any disability, fully able person, I struggle to find it out or contact this page. It is in the left side, last item is given. If you are bringing it the second item, it won't be, you know, it is not a predictable manner. Go with the predictable way. When I was in the college or doing those days, even I used to develop a website or something, when I was trying to make it so flashy and, you know, kind of these kind of things, but that may not be usable by all the people. So make sure it is following this principle. The last one is robust. Robust as in, you know, it should be understandable or interpretable by all the user agents. For example, if you're using browser, mobile, or, you know, whatever it is, tablet, whatever it is, it should be understandable. And, you know, if, let's say browser, if you're using a screen reader, one simple example is that in some website, people use div instead of button. So screen reader may not be understand or may not be able to convey to say that it is using, you know, or it has some clickable operation, it is there, it may not realize. So try to use the standard controls everywhere. There might be some situation you have to use the alternate approach, but try to your level best, try to use the standard controls. And there are some rate success criteria or rating, like A being the lowest one, like how well you are in your application, which of the principles or guidelines you're following. Based on that, there will be certain guidelines, A, AA, AAA, where A being the least and AAA being the best or most accessible system. So we'll take one quick example with the D360 CHAMPS, this iconic. This is totally readable, but what I'm saying, mostly we are using CHAMPS in the white background where it is totally readable and fully AAA rated. But you know, with the current this background, I'm not talking about this one, the small one part of the community. If I take this one, if I use the, this is now okay, but if I use a font size lower than the current font size, it may not meet the AA rating. Because if a person with color blindness, they might be seeing as shown over here. You can go to contrastchecker.com or there are many browser plugins available. You can just simply check that your color is in sync with the standards. What are the ratings it is following? Let's say if I'm using one more font size lower than the current one, it may fall into this category, like even may go to single A. One, like not the AA one, but this is okay. But if I reduce a font size more, people may struggle to read it. But this looks so neat and nice with these two colors, but this is thing. For some people, it may look very this thing, but people with a high disability or severe disability may struggle to read it. So this is something we may not notice something, but you know, as and when we may become more aware of accessibility concerns, we will try to check these aspects. Even if I go back to like 90% of the application which I created before, which may fall, I think, not even AA, maybe single A. So these are the things we may miss out, but you know, you can make it better with the small things. Like, you know, if you release one more font size, it may fall below AA, but if you, the current one is good. That's what I'm saying, you are in the correct verge. If you increase one more, it will become maybe, it is like you become like AAA or something like that. But you know, it varies. So this is it, and these are some of the high level principle and overviews. I hope you have now a high level understanding what are these accessibility things and what all things you need to consider. Now, let's share some stories of personal experience before we go to the application side. Some of my personal experience I'll tell, and some of my friends' experience, two, three things. You know, I won't take much of time. I know it may be a bit boring to tell all the stories, but you know, just try. There is a reason. I'll tell you why I'm going to tell, why I'm saying all these things. There is a reason also. Okay, for me personally, I have kind of a manageable, but still I have dysgraphia. Dysgraphia means a form where you cannot move your fingers as you wish. Like there is some limitation. Like this is prominent when you write or type something, you know, the things, it is not like my handwriting is bad. It is something like, you know, I cannot read what I have written after 5 minutes. It is very difficult. I may miss out the spellings. I may miss out words. Sometimes I may even miss out the entire word, or sometimes I will jumble between words. I will jumble the spelling in between. That is not a complex words for the very simple one. And typing, you know, it is kind of manageable. So we have some tools and autocorrection, Grammarly, and all the things. Actually, these things are making, these facilities are making my life much better. But, you know, if I write, even I will be confusing, totally confused with the spacing. Sometimes I write two words together, and sometimes I put, you know, three times space in between one single word. So this is the way I write. So when I was a kid, you know, basically, if these accessible features were 20 years back, I might have taken my bachelor's and master's in chemistry or some other subject. But when I was in high school, except I realized, no, I'm going to be the computer side because I cannot write all the records assignments for the science streams. So I went with the computer science back. That's the reason I went with computer science stream itself. You know, those days when people doesn't know this is kind of a limitation or something, people tried. Even I was in college, I used to write the copywriting. My teachers asked me, you do copywriting, you will improve. Can you imagine a person doing master's, teachers are asking him to do a copywriting? I used to do that thing, you know. And when I was doing my master's, you know, there was a top subject. One of my elective was management. That was my favorite subject. I used to read newspapers and magazines and journals every day. So I can relate to everything, what is happening around the business industry and the management principles and everything. It was my favorite subject. I studied it well. And for my main examination, that was the exam which I enjoyed the most. I wrote it very clearly. I used maximum purpose. And I was very confident about the exam other than apart from all other examinations, all other purpose. And I was waiting for the result. And when the result came in, you know, I was one of the very few students who failed in that subject. I cannot blame the college or the teachers. They cannot read what I have written over there. You know, out of 60, only three or four people failed for that subject. That was kind of an easy paper. And for me, that was my favorite subject. I failed. Though I didn't show that outside. I went into kind of a very depression mode. You know, I studied well. I was confused what, how I'm going to survive in the world. I cannot tell anyone else. People may say, because you're not practicing or you're not writing well. This is the blame I used to get. But I was not able to pass for my favorite subject itself. So this is the reason even, you know, Deepa initially explained about the comic strip I went. You know, I'm using comic strip. To write a blog, complete blog post, it will take double the time a normal person would take. I am actually jealous of people who publish blogs every week, because for me, it will take more time. And sometimes I depend on my wife. She will proofread that thing, because if I write a single paragraph, type in a single paragraph, there will be three mistakes minimum. So that's the way even there are people in this section itself asking me, why are you not writing or preparing a video or blog for this thing? To prepare the script or article, it may take, for me, on a single, this thing may take some time, 1 or 2 days. Even for this presentation tech, it took a couple of days for me to prepare and proof it, like maybe 2 to 3 days. It's just less than 20 PPT, but slides. But, you know, it is manageable. I'm managing it. I'm not saying this is a very disability. I need special attention, nothing. I can manage it. It is manageable. Again, another thing I told you, like I may go faster. I used to be a kid who cannot speak properly. I have severe stammering when I was a very small kid. Still now, I cannot pronounce certain words. Fortunately, for this thing, my parents was very supportive. When I was very younger, like, you know, maybe 5 year or 4 year, they used to ask me to join all the competition, elocutions, debates, or extempore. Wherever there's an opportunity to speak up, they forced me to join it. There were instances when I came off the stage crying without saying a single word, because I cannot pronounce the word. But for this competition, I started practicing all the words in front of a mirror or sitting alone. So I have, my vocabulary is limited, because I cannot speak a new word, say a new word without practicing it. Or sometimes I may stuck, you know, especially in public speaking. If I try certain words, I know I should not be using these words in public, because I may get stuck. So this is I'm saying these are not disability. I can this is manageable. With constant practice, I'm managing it to an extent. So even sometimes, even now I speak alone, I sit in a room and practice where I speak alone. Initially, my wife used to thought, yeah, I have some problem because he always go to this room and talk things. So basically, these are some limitations, which this is the first time I'm saying in a public place, I have these problems, but people may not know we have these limitations. And when I was in college, one of my friend, she was designing, back in those days, flash games were there. She was designing a flash game and, she was creating some screen order animation. All of a sudden, she fainted back, fainted. Then we asked, what happened? She doesn't know. I was looking at the screen and I don't know what happened. And I was concerned, what happened? Then when I was, I think 1 or 2 years back, my office, we went for a party and outing, and on a party time, one of my colleague, she also fainted down when everyone was at the stage and dancing parting time. The problem was there was a flickering light. The light, she had something called light epilepsy. So they are sensitive to photos, photosensitive people, they have some issues with the light. So what happens is that when screen animations or the loaded screen or the light you use, that may disturb them knowingly or unknowingly. These people doesn't know they have this problem, but this is the actual problem. So why I'm saying this, these things are, there are people, which others don't know or doesn't know these people have this kind of a limitation. So when you develop an application, the other limitation we spoke are visible limitation or physical limitation. A person is blind or he has some hearing problem. He is using a hearing aid or he's using a wheelchair. We know these people has this problem, but there are people who doesn't want to tell to others, see, I have this problem, or people sometimes they don't know they have these problems. So the mobile app, the power app, or the chart you designed might be or might not be usable for others, or making their life harder, or maybe even disturbing the animation or the loader screen, you develop might be disturbing others, which they don't want to tell to others. So this is a serious problem. Think about my friend who fainted seeing an animation on the screen, and you are using a very flashy website, or in the canvas or pixel, you are using a very flashy blinking animation or some kind of a user experience to show something is happening on the screen. It might be the manager. She might faint. And what happened during a UAT? This is happening. What will you do? I'm not saying in a funny way, but take it very seriously or on an empathetic or sympathetic manner. They paid some money, but they're not able to use. Every time they come to the office, they started using your application. In their mind, they might be struggling. They might be sparing you as well. These are the things. Sometimes you need to be very aware and careful. That's why I thought to speak about this thing. I'm not very expert on the accessibility side. Even though I have these limitations, I also just think about my own side. Okay, I make sure spell check is there, or I'm giving enough time to complete a form. I'm doing the timeouts with proper time delay. These things I will consider because I know I will take more time. But I might not be thinking about the photosensitive issue, or I might not be saying or considering people with some color blindness. This is the problem with everyone. We just think about ourselves. But when you develop an application as a responsive manager or a developer, try to include as possible. I know this will take hours to make application fully accessible. We may not have the budget for it, but you can do simple things. Maybe the tabbing or the color naming, text alternative, these things you can do. Just don't skip the simple things. So, okay, that's all with the story. Now go to the real Power App side and we see what all things we can do. There are many things which still we can do, but just on the high level things. If you go to there is an official guidelines. I'll do one thing. I will just reshare my entire screen so that I can share the app as well. So. I hope you can see my complete screen. So
I guess we can see next.
Yeah, there is a Microsoft complete guidelines around 36 page how to make your Power App fully accessible. I'm not going to explain each and everything, just the high level things again. So you can go and download this one. I will paste the link in the chat. Where is it? Okay, I will paste in the chat so that you can refer to this guideline. This is the Microsoft official guideline, so you can use this guideline to make your app more accessible for others. So, this is 35th page. Okay, now coming to Power Apps side. Let me take my presentation. I know this is the most pathetic way to show a presentation, but I'm just showing. Okay, this is the official guideline. Then the official guidelines explains about the layout and the color components you should be using in the Power App. By default, the standard color combination, the Power App is accessible. It meets the AAA category, so you can use that. But if you're changing the color codes, make sure you follow the best practice. Then keyboard support, it should be supporting the tabbing. Then screen reader support, and there should be a logical flow. And with the multimedia, there should be some alternate text for all the multimedia in a screen. So let's go back to Power App. So I have an app called Accessible App. For saving time, I have developed an application. I'm not showing from scratch how to develop it, but this is a simple screen. This is not actually a functioning application, just a dummy screen only. This is a standard screen I developed. I have label and text input over here. I have a toggle bar over here, submit button over here. So you can see, I'll show you the place where I developed also. Let's go to the studio, maker portal, and yes. This is the one I have given the name screen one, and I haven't given proper name to all the controls, but bear with me that. So this is it. And these are the controls. I placed it over here. So these are the controls. So now let's flip back to the application. I pressed over here and clicking on the tab key. It went down from H, it went to email. I actually want the people feel there are two sides. This is the personal detail and these are the contact details. I want them to fill in all these side and this side. But from here, it went to email. See, if a person is not using a mouse or touch screen, he is using on a laptop or a supportive system with a keyboard. He went from here to here. Then if we click, it didn't go to here. It came to web. Then it came to this control. Then it went to submit. It didn't take the user to country or job title attributes. So people, if let's say you are a person with a disability, is using your application using a tab key, they may not be able to navigate this thing properly, but if you test with your touch screen or mobile device, tablet or mouse, you are able to navigate to everything. But if for a person with a slight disability, he may not be able to use the application. This is the thing sometimes we may miss out when you develop an application. So to do that thing, what we do, I have created another screen also in the application. For the interest of time only, I have this thing designed in advance. So I used a vertical container over here. So with the Microsoft default screen reader or tabbing property, what it goes in an asset manner. From here, this one, from this is kind of a manner it will be following. Like, from the left topmost left corner, it will go to the right top item, then to the next below that. I think this is order it is following. But if you use a container, but the tabbing will go inside the container and it will tab through all the controls inside the container. Then it will move to the next container. I have a second container called contact details. And this is my container called personal details. So the flow it will take is that it will take this attribute first, then this one, I'll show in action. So if you flip back to the application, I have this in another screen. This is the second screen application form. From here, if I tab in, you can see it went from name, age, job title, country, email, mobile, web, notification, and to the submit button. So with a small thing, I didn't do much, I didn't spend much time. I just created a container and put the controls neatly inside a container. I know most of you are using containers and rectangles to make it properly, arrange things properly, but just realize this is one side of it. Apart from the other advantages, this is one important advantage which disabled people can face. So,
one second, Nijo, I'll try and.
Yep. Thank you. So, this is one of the accessibility side which you can make. Now, coming back, how you can check all this accessible side. I know you have seen this thing many times. If you go to the apps checker, you can see from here, there is an accessibility tab. Microsoft Excel showing all the errors in your application. Missing tab is not properly managed. you know, accessible label is not there. I'll tell you what is the importance of accessible label. You know, these are the, these controls are missing accessible tables, and you know, order is not properly ordered. And see the screen, the first screen, I haven't given a screen name. I have simply given screen name. We may think that this is nobody is going to see, or I might give some kind of a protocol manner name like screen SSCR underscore one or screen APP form, something like that. But when you use a screen reader, it is reading that thing, and it may not convey any proper meaning to the person who is using it. Try to give a proper name, application submission form. So when he is using the screen reader will read it out, saying application submission form, so that the user can understand he or she is in the application submission form. So we'll see what is accessibility level, or let's see for this application, this field, I haven't given any accessibility label. So when I go to screen reader, it will simply say text input. So the user may not understand what to enter here. So if I'm using a screen reader, he cannot see it properly. He is just maybe blurred vision only. He is using a screen reader. The screen reader will read out a text input, or again here age also. This is a text field. Again, it will say text input, or come to here no, or toggle bar. Simply say toggle button, or it will come to here button. So they may not get what is the intended purpose of that particular attribute or operation over here. But if you come to here, this is my accessible form. We come out here. I'm taking this one, and I have given an accessible label. Enter your full name here, so that the screen reader will read out. Enter your full name here, so that he can understand this attribute is for entering my name. Screen reader will read it out. Let me see if I can show that thing in action. I'm just turning on the screen. Please let me know if you are able to hear the screen reader audio. I'm just trying to see, are you able to hear the audio?
Not yet.
Okay.
You have to enable the sound
through audio.
Yeah. Let me see. I may have to share the system audio also for that thing.
Yes, yeah.
Can you help me with
Reshare it, Nijo.
Okay.
So unshare your screen. Yeah.
Sharing it.
Share it with video.
No, share it with system audio. When you share it, it will give you a button for
yes,
system.
Yes, I got it. It is called include computer sound. That is the controller.
Yeah, include computer sound.
Yes, I'm including it. So I'm just turning on the narrator.
Start narrator dialogue. Narrator heading level 1. Power apps window. Pane. C. Published application by App Magic. Screen 1. Group.
Okay.
Volume level 97. Screen 1 application form name mobile edit. Edit. A Gmail edit. Edit. Country web edit. Edit. Receive notifications, job title edit, no button, exiting narrator.
So we had the narration from the inaccessible form, like app standard form, which I decided initially. You can see it's simply saying it read out the name label, name edit. It is not properly conveying any. Sometimes people may know, like since I have the labels over here, it is reading it out. But when you came to here, like receive notification, it did not convey the meaning properly. Since I have all the labels, it read country edit, so that people can use it. But you know, again, that's not a good approach. Let's go to the other screen with all the controls and explanations, accessible label. I'm just gonna try turn on the narrator again.
Narrator dialogue. Okay, narrator heading level 1. Power apps window. Pane. Application submission form. Application form. Published application by App Magic. Application submission form heading level 1. Application form. Go to inaccessible screen. Image. Name. Enter your full name here. Edit. Your name. Age. Please enter your age as of today. Edit. Job title. Please enter your current job title. Edit. Country. Please enter your country of residence. Edit. Email. Please enter your email. Edit. Mobile, please enter your mobile number with country code. Edit. Web, please enter your web address if applicable. Edit. Receive notifications, no button. Exiting narrator.
So I hope you were able to hear the proper narration. Just saying, I haven't shown the full use because how a blind person or people with lower vision use the application. Actually, they have the proper keys. I'm not very familiar with those keys, but when it says edit, I can click on control. I can stop, pause the narrator. I can type in, then I can start the narration again. So that's how they use, but it is giving proper name, meaning. As you saw here, I have given the accessibility label. So when the narrator reaches here, it will tell what this field is for or what you have to enter over here, what you need, what is the operation you can do out here. So these are the simple things we can follow. So two things we saw. One is the keyboard operation. Second one is making the accessible for people with disabilities, like vision problem. Then we already saw how we can use the color contrast or the coloring, which best approaches for color contrast. There are tools like contrast checker, this checker, or there are browser add-ons you can use to make understand how or how good your color contrast ratio is, so that you can make it more accessible for people. So these are the some of the considerations you can do. Now I would like to give a simple bonus also. So you can go to the community sample page. There is an application by Sangha Harkis, which is instant accessibility branding template. So you can simply search for branding template V2. That is a standard app with templates for accessibility. I know if you are going to develop an application that's fully accessible, it will take a lot of time. It may not be fit in your development budget because you have to go and add all these things. You have to check for the color contrast. It is sometimes it may not be viable or practical within the due to budget constraints if you're developing an application, or time constraints if you're developing an application. For a standard application, if you're developing for especially if an disabled or disabled make it accessible, you may have the budget, but you may not have the budget in such cases. What you can do is that you can use his template. That template has standard kind of things to make your app more accessible, or which follows all the AA rating principles. With a single click, you can make it your app, or you can theme your app accordingly using that thing. That's a bonus point. I think I had takes almost, I took almost 15 minutes. So that's it for my time. I know I haven't gone through or shown all the things, but I hope you got an awareness. This is what my intention was, to make kind of an awareness session. I think you have an awareness now. Just try to make your app or whatever you do accessible for everyone. So that's how we can make the world a better place for this. Thank you. Time for any questions.
Thank you, Nijo, for a wonderful topic, a different thing which we need to think about in terms of making an app or interface more utilizable for everyone, right? Ankush, are there any questions in the chat window?
Not right now. Team, any questions? If you want to ask, you can ask Nijo. We still have 12 minutes for the next session.
There won't be much more questions because it is more of a theory kind of a side,
No, but it's a new thing for all of us actually. So a new learning, like how power like you can have accessibility things in the Power Apps, and you gave your example, which was kudos to you actually. So most of the people won't be explaining their limitation or the concern. So great.
All right, so that's okay.